I'm Justin DeLay from Reverb.com, and in this series, we're going to take an introductory look at the world of synthesis. Let's start at the very beginning with oscillators. Now, the oscillator in your synthesizer is the foundational circuit that actually generates sound. How does it do that? Well, oscillators generate a variety of basic waveforms. Literally, the vibrations in the air that our ears pick up and perceive as sound. And the shape of these basic waveforms is what gives it the characteristic that forms the foundation of your synthesized sound. So, let's listen and take a look at a couple of basic waveforms, and then later, we'll figure out how to put it all together. Okay, first, let's take a look and a listen at saw waves. Sounds like this. Okay, so you can hear it. That's just the raw oscillator generating that sawtooth waveform. And you can hear a lot of excitement, a lot of brightness in the high end. And it's really, really great for synthesizing sounds like strings, where you really want to get some of that energy and excitement in the upper range. Now, next we have the square wave, which looks and sounds like this. Still a big, full sound, but what separates the square wave from the saw wave is it's a little bit rounder, potentially a little bit more vocal, can get very reedy, can get very almost horn-based, and really provides just a ton of harmonic complexity to then shape further. All right, next we're going to take a listen to a triangle wave. Sounds like this. Cool. Now, you're probably thinking, doesn't sound quite as lively or as full as the sawtooth or the square wave, and you would be right. The triangle is going to be a much purer, more dull sound. And the reason for that starts to get into the world of harmonics and frequency analysis, which we're gonna take a closer look at in a future episode. But for now, from a basic perspective, if you're looking to make something a little bit more pure, a little bit more dull, start with a triangle wave. If you're looking for something that's a little bit more aggressive, has a little bit more high end, a little bit more raspiness, try a saw wave, try a square wave. There is another kind of oscillator waveform, and that is noise. And noise sounds like this. Now, you may say to yourself, why would I need noise sounds in my synthesizer? And there are several good reasons for that. One, maybe you just really need to make the sound of TV static for your composition. Maybe you want to take that noise and combine it with another waveform to create a little bit more energy and sonic excitement in your sound. All of which is to say, many synthesizers have a noise source, and it can be an awesome effect, an awesome secondary color to your sound, and it's always fun to make noise. And if nothing else, when you're playing your synth and you've got a sound in your head, if you don't feel like you're really getting the basic character that you're going for, first knob I would reach for is your waveform. Give it a flick. Might take your sound in an entirely new direction. Thank you. That was a quick look and listen at basic oscillator waveforms. Check out the next episode where we actually start putting oscillator waveforms together and building up full synthesized sounds.